So today I'm directing my cabinet, even as we're signing the bill, to implement some of Joe's recommendations. First, we're going to use the funds and programs we already have in a smarter way. Federal agencies will award grants that move away from what our Secretary of Labor, Tom Perez, who's been working very hard on this, what he calls a train and pray approach. And I'll bet a lot of you who have dealt with folks who are unemployed know what that means. They enroll, they get trained for something, they're not even sure whether the job's out there, and if the job isn't out there, all they're doing is saddling themselves with debt, oftentimes putting themselves in a worse position. What we want to do is make sure where you train your workers first based on what employers are telling you they're hiring for. Help business design the training programs so that we're creating a pipeline into jobs that are actually out there. Number two, training programs that use federal money will be required to make public how many of its graduates find jobs and how much they earn. And that means workers, as they're shopping around for what's available, they'll know in advance if they can expect a good return on their investment. Every job seeker should have all the tools they need to take their career into their own hands. And we're going to help make sure they can do that. And finally, we're going to keep investing in new strategies and innovations that help keep pace with a rapidly changing economy, from testing new, faster ways of teaching skills like coding and cybersecurity and welding, to giving at-risk youth the chance to learn on the job. We will keep making sure that Americans have the chance to build their careers throughout a lifetime of hard work. So the bill I'm signing today and the actions I'm taking today will connect more ready-to-work Americans with ready-to-be-filled jobs.